Can you guess the name of the New England city that recently unearthed an African burial ground? A. Newburyport. B. Provincetown. C. Bristol, Rhode Island. Or D. Portsmouth, New Hampshire. The answer is D. Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Nestled within a city block in the middle of downtown, Portsmouth's African burying ground is difficult to miss. But for more than 200 years, the site was hidden, almost lost.
Just like anything that says a treasure or hidden, once you open that box, you have no idea what you're going to find. But there's these little nuggets, there's beauty, and it gives us an opportunity to look at this history, not just as white history, black history, but an inclusive history that's American history.
Local history buffs knew slaves were buried in this vicinity, but no one knew exactly where the burial site was. That was until it was unearthed in 2003.
Contractors working in this city street unexpectedly uncovered a series of hexagonal wooden coffins and human remains from this section of the street right here. We did additional archaeological and forensic analysis to confirm that these remains were in fact of African descent.
The first African slaves arrived in Portsmouth sometime in the late 1600s, and this area was an active burial site for nearly 200 years. Though the individual stories of the buried are unknown, the city and volunteers spent 8 years raising money and commissioning art and historical writings to make the memorial a living expression of the slaves who helped shape the city's history.
The title of this memorial site we have here, We Stand in Honor of Those Forgotten. The entry piece is intended to invite you into the site. It is a place where you have representative figures of African descent. They reach around toward one another. One represents who we refer to as Mother Africa. On the other side is representative of her son, that first enslaved person we are aware of who came to Portsmouth in 1645. He looks down towards the rest of the site, towards the burial vault, where we have the Sankofa symbol, which is a West African Adinkra symbol, meaning return and get it, learn from the past. Underneath that symbol is buried the remains of those we exhumed in 2003. Around the burial vault tomb is a semicircular series of 8 standing figures. You don't see their faces. You cannot tell their gender. You can't tell their creed. They represent the modern community of Portsmouth. We stand in honor of those forgotten.
During a dedication ceremony, city residents stood together and returned the discovered bodies to the ground. A proper burial and touching tribute to an almost overlooked part of Portsmouth's past.
The day of the unveiling the reinterment was emotional for everybody. The most visceral feeling was when we were putting the remains in the vault and I looked around at the faces of the African-American men. They were the pallbearers, and you could feel the emotion in their face, the sense that we've done something right.
In 1779, 20 enslaved men petitioned for their freedom in a letter sent to the New Hampshire State Legislature. Those men were never freed, but in a tribute to their efforts, some of the lines from that letter are now engraved on the burying ground site. And that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. I'm Anthony Everett. Hope to see you back here again soon for another edition of Chronicle.